Now this is what lettuce is supposed to be like. You don't just cut it when it's all small, you know, when it's grown out to here and you have a little clump of lettuce. You just pick off the bottom leaves and you just slowly let the lettuce keep growing up while you pick off the leaves to eat. And then eventually you get to what will be the top of the lettuce, which here are some seeds. Unfortunately, looks like something bit into here and broke our little seeds, which is really unfortunate. Probably an earwig. Might be something else though. But yeah, this is how you get the most lettuce that you can get. And this was one of those lettuces that you get in the store that they give you that still has the roots left in it. Well, I planted three of them. Unfortunately, the other two were harvested when they were really small, but I got my parents to leave this one, let it keep growing, and just picking off leaves as they go. And as you can see, it has done extremely well. Like, so well. I'm just blown away at how well it's done. Actually, everything in my little container garden up here has done really well. Even these late tomatoes that I planted. I planted like I would just put a handful of seeds in there. Like I'd put a tomato in there basically, and all the seeds germinated basically. And they gave me all these tomato plants, and I've been culling them as we go. If they're, you know, like all these like little ones, I'd be culling them. But we've got to a point now that, you know, I can just kind of let some of them stay. It's not a big deal. It's not really causing issues at the moment. But yeah, it was great. And got a bunch of tomatoes from them, which is great because the tomatoes in the garden got hit by, I'm assuming, powdery mildew from the, oh, we got a rabbit down there. From the zucchini plants. And which really sucks because it completely destroyed all the tomato plants. I'm assuming that it was some sort of fungi from the zucchini plants because they got covered in powdery mildew. And then those got hit and lost. So I'm glad that these ones are all producing tomatoes. These are other examples of me just throwing some seeds into a little container. I think these ones were cherry tomatoes. Again, started very late. These ones like way late in the season, maybe like a month ago. Not really sure how long it's been, but I know I could get them even bigger if I put them into bigger containers and then fed them, you know, gave them all the nutrients and love that they need. And then over here, well, actually, while we're here, this is, we have some apple trees in here, which one of them's just destroyed now. The slugs are destroying them. I really wish, though, that I planted these into the ground at some point because I don't know if I'm gonna be able to overwinter them. Like, I can try. I don't know if it's going to survive. I don't know if I should go plant it somewhere outside and then cover it with a dome or something for the winter. I just don't know. But then in this plant here, in this container, I put a mint plant last year. Was it last year? Yeah. And I put in last summer. And then this pot just sat in the corner there all winter long, completely exposed to the conditions. So it definitely froze, but the plant didn't die. Obviously, it stayed alive. And I'm glad that I chose the mint plant to put in here because this year it's done so well. Like, look at some of these leaves. They're just massive, absolutely massive. Unfortunately, I haven't been here to harvest it as much as I want to. And so you can see it's taken some damage from either slugs or maybe let's see, earwigs, maybe even Japanese beetles, I'm not 100% sure, but you can see it's really branched out, like really branched out. I haven't seen too many mint plants. Well, this year I have. I've seen them branch out crazy like this, but I didn't know that that's what they did. Oh, Jesus, got scared there. Whew, jumped. Yeah, so that's my mint plant bush. And I also threw this was just a little cutting of rosemary that I put in there this past year. I think at the start of the year I put it in, and just to see if I could get it going. I think it was this year, maybe it was last year. I don't remember now. I don't think it was last year. If it was last year, it would have grown by now. It wouldn't be still green like that little bit, right? Anyways, we'll see how that goes. And then in here, actually, let's go to this one first. This one's just, looks like just a grass, some sort of grass. I'm not sure what it is. And this one, though, we have a pepper plant, which I'm 99% sure these pepper plants that are here, that they're bell peppers. 99% sure that's what I did. There was an orange bell pepper that I ended up throwing in there. Just a bunch of seeds, and they were destroyed by the slugs. Like when they were just wee little lads like this tall, they all got destroyed. And so the fact that there's like one, two, three, four, five big ones, like, and one much thicker than the others, actual pepper plants that made it, I'm really happy for, really, really happy that they made it. Because, you know, just goes to show that life can find a way. And I don't know what this one is. I'll have to double check what this one is. I did plant just a couple random cuttings. I just took some cuttings and kind of threw them in some of these to see if they would grow, or just random seeds from plants that are around the yard or the house or whatever. But this one, I have no idea. Like, if you look at this, this is wild. I don't know what I did to get this to grow. I'm assuming it's the same grass that's in that one, and this just really took off. But like, whoa. I'm gonna have to look it up and see what this is, because I am so surprised that it made it and did this well. These leaves are so thick, and to me it just kind of came out of nowhere, but it's really nice. Is it corn? Is that corn? Did I put corn in there? Did I plant corn? I don't think I planted corn. That can't be corn. Can it? No. It wouldn't be corn. Those aren't... That's not corn. Right? No, that's not a cob of corn. No. I don't think so. But anyways, really, really interesting. And I'll have to pick a screenshot of this video so I can put it into the app and figure out what it is. Same with this one as well. Figure out what that one is too. Get a good shot of it there. And I don't know what that red spots are. I'm assuming some sort of disease. Hopefully not, but bug bite maybe. I'm not sure. Anyways, I gotta end it there because I still got some more work to do before I head out. So thanks for checking it out. Again, thank you, lettuce, for feeding us, tomatoes, for bleeding us, and yeah, everyone else, thank you for letting me speak for you. Thank you for eating us. All right, peace.